I said, let's smoke it out. Well, apparently, who smoked it in? Well, hello, my beauties, and welcome to my channel. Today, I'm going to test out eye brushes from AliExpress. These are Jessup brushes. I have seen them on AliExpress on numerous occasions. However, I had never tried them. I did try the Bailey brushes that I still use. I will link the video down below where I test them out. It was almost a year ago, but I still use quite a few of those brushes. But Make Me Up Missa always raves about Jessup brushes, and I thought, let me try them. So here I have an eyeshadow brush set. They came really well packaged. They were here really quickly as well. I think it was a week. So that is very, very good. I did wash them yesterday because I wanted to wash them. They felt a little bit stiff and a little bit not... how am I going to explain that? They were soft, but not as soft as they probably should be. So yeah, I washed them, so they are clean. First impression without using them after having washed them, I can kind of see that the hairs go a little bit. Yeah, it doesn't hold its shape that well. I think this is the one that you can see it the best, but I don't know if you can even see it. Because my hand is pretty light, so let me do this. Can you see it now? I hope so. The same thing happens with some of the Morphe brushes that I have. So yeah, it is not really, really weird. I paid 13 euros for this set, which is an eye brush set, contains of a bunch of brushes. It's a very nice kit. I will leave the kit and the seller where I got them down below. But I thought, let's play with them. This one I did not use because I have already done my concealer. So this is, yeah, I can try it for an eyeshadow base, to blend out my eyeshadow base or concealer. I have something like this from Bailey that I actually really like, so I will use this for that. So let me grab my eyeshadow base that I'm going to use for today. Which one? I don't know yet. So I have here, because of the eyeshadow palette that I'm going to use is pretty lightish, I want my Essence eyeshadow base to intensify the color. So let me prime my eyes with that brush, or at least blend out with that brush. So I'm pretty curious, seeing kind of how they look now. They do remind me a bit of Morphe brushes. I know that Make Me Up Missa says that they are a nice dupe for Zoeva brushes. Now I do have to say, if I'm paying Zoeva money, which is I think around 50 euros or something along those lines for a kit like this, I want better quality. Just saying. But that's me. Oh yeah, and I haven't done my brows yet because there's also a brow brush here. I almost forgot. Okay, so there's the eyeshadow base. Yeah, it did its job. I don't really know what to say about it. I could also use something like this. This one to tap it out. This one is the Luxe All Over Shader, the 222. And this one was the 142 Concealer Buffer. You could use this for, I don't know, setting your eyeshadow base. I have no idea, people. I don't usually do that. But yeah, let me... let's let this sit a little bit. So let me kind of see if I can get something going on with my brows then. And we can let the eyeshadow base stay tacky. Okay, the set didn't come with a spoolie, by the way. So I usually use a brow pencil. Where did I put my thing? But I also have this. This is a brow powder from BB that I got in one of the boxes. Let's use this one. And then we have here the brow liner, which is pretty big for my brow, I think. But I also have a detailed liner, and I have a wing liner. This one is a little bit too wide. This one is nice and narrow, so I will probably like this one as well. But let's try this one. I don't know, people. Let's see what I can do. I usually don't really use brow powder. It does seem to pick up a nice amount. I'm so not proficient with a brow powder. Can you tell? it does work a lot better than the brush I used before. So yeah, I'm not really hating this brush, to be quite honest with you. Okay, I think that's good. Let me get my... Where is it? Oh yeah. Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. She's a stinky one, but she works like a charm. It's actually the only thing that I have so far that kinda keeps my brows, my rambunctious brows, where I kinda want them. The only thing though is that here, I don't know if it is me, it could very well be me or my brow. I don't know, people. Again, I don't usually use a powder. Now it is like I have a gap in my brow, what the hell? You know what? Let me get my pencil. That's better. Maybe I had another shaving accident. It could very well be that. Brows are kind of done. It's a very nice brush. I'm just not proficient with doing my brows like that. So, yeah. I actually thought, let's play with the coffee palette. From what I saw of my comments that you guys left me on my other videos, you really, really like the coffee palette. So I thought, let me use it again. Yeah, so I'm going to start with this one, which is the Petite Eye Blender. But the reason I'm grabbing this is because it is the densest one that it is for the eyes. I'm going to go into the color Caffeine, which is this one. That one. And I'm going to stamp it on my eye. I'm going to start in the inner part. Let's see if I can make it show up today, because in my first impression on the lower lash line, it did not want to show up, but that was on a set base. And now we have a non-set base. Okay. So it picks up a nice amount of shadow, which is good. I think this is a dual fiber brush. Looking at the handles. Or at the hairs, I mean. And a color like this, I pack on and kind of leave alone. If I want to blend, I will blend the edges only. I'm also going to stamp it on my lower lash line. Actually, this brush, the size of this brush is perfect for that. At least for my eyes it is. Let's blend a little bit. So let me get, what is this? The Luxe Crease. It is clean because I washed it yesterday. I'm just going to concentrate this on the edge. And the nice thing I see about this one, this is a bit longer, but has a little bit of a tip. And it is not really flimsy. It is a little bit more stiff. And that is usually what I like in my brushes a lot of the time. I'm going to go back into the color Caffeine with this brush. Let's see what it picks up. Picks up a nice amount. And it is, I'm blending it into the crease because I want to use it. It's very, very nice for the crease. Yeah, I like this brush actually. I like the fact that it is a little bit stiffer than normal. Okay, let me go into the color called Baby Chino. I'm going to kind of blend the top edge a little bit. Going to go back into the color Caffeine, which was the purpley. Okay, the next brush is going to be the Luxe Petite. And I want to deepen everything up a little bit. Let's go crazy. And let's go to Americano. Ooh, wow. And I'm going to put this in the crease. And this is the, what did I say? The Petite Crease, which is perfect for the work that I want to do. And this one is also a bit stiffer. But the nice thing about that is, because it is a bit stiffer, it kind of deposits the shadow really where I want it. Instead of going flimsy and all over the place. For my eye shape and how I want my eye shape to look and my shadow to look, this one is actually perfect. I think I can order them separately as well. So maybe I need a few extra of these 2-to-1s. Because, yeah, wow, nice. Now, I also have one here that is the Soft Crease, the 2-to-1. Ah, yeah. Perfect for blending the two together. I want the brownie shade a bit higher up. With this brush, I'm going to go into the color called Caffeine. First one that I used. I'm going to replace it, re-intensify it a bit. Yeah, this is a shade that needs to be placed on a tacky base if you really want it to show up. Or at least for my skin tone. So there's that. Yeah, so these, this one feels, as I said, stiffer but not scratchy. And I have two 514s from Morphe, which are a little bit scratchy. It's not that they hurt, but they are a little bit scratchy. But that does mean that they can distribute product really, really nicely. I do, however, prefer this one, I think. So yeah, there's that. Underneath my eye, let's you know, smoke it out with the color Americano, the brown. Let's go smoke it out underneath. It's a little bit more heavy than I had planned. But yeah, what can you do about it? Okay, then I have here the Luxe Soft Definer. I'm going to smoke out my lower lash line. Okay, for my lid, I'm going to grab a shimmer. It does not really need a glitter primer, but I want to see, I actually want to see what it does without. So I'm just going to go there with the color Bean. I'm doing a neutral look today, people. I don't know what's happening. Maybe I'm sick. Let's see how it picks up shadow. Ooh, it picks up shadow actually really, really nicely. And it actually places it pretty well as well. However, I want to use my glitter primer. So I have my NYX glitter primer on the brush. I also have a small brush here. But let's see what this one does. And this says cream shader, so you could also use it for cream products, but also for cut creases probably. I'm going to go into the color Bean that I just used. Yeah, let's also get the color Roast. I'm just going to flip the brush, and this one has a nice tip, so I don't need a tiny brush just yet. I'm just going to place it here in the inner part. I'm kind of going to fade it over so like that I can... I cannot talk. Let's try this one. It is a smudger, but still. So I'm going to go into the color Bean. I'm going to spray, and I'm going to put that on my lower lash line. Let's get the color called Iced. Because I can. That's basically the only reason. Yeah, this one is a little bit kind of glittery sheer, so I'm going to spray. These types of tiny brushes, I have a few of these. I really, really like them. I want to make it a little bit more pink because even though it was actually purple, it kind of went pink on my eye, but I'm kind of missing it there. So I'm going to grab the color Decaf. And I'm going to, I don't know, grab it on this one, which is actually the smoky shader. And this is also a little bit more of a sheerer formula, but let's see what happens if I dust it over. And yeah, that's the kind of pinkiness that I wanted, so that's good. And then a little bit of that Iced white, a little bit more on the inner corner. So I have here an eye pencil from Essence, Electric Vibes in the color No Regrets. I'm going to put that in my waterline. And I'm going to put it on top of my lashes. And then probably smoke it out a bit. Let's use a smudger. I'm going to clean it on the towel. Then I'm going to go into the color Decaf, which was that pink shimmer. I like that. Anyway. Let me recreate that on the other eye too. Let's see if I can kind of get that pencil up here as well. And then I get that smudgy brush again. I hope it doesn't look like I have pink eye. That's okay.
Maybe you should have thought of that before. Yes, maybe I should have.
But I didn't. I quite like the way this one smudges. I usually don't use brushes like this a lot, but it's nice. So I have here that Luxe pencil brush. I'm going to go into the color Iced again, which was the white. I'm just going to reposition a little bit in the inner corner, and this is actually perfect for that. Cool. Okay, liner. I usually don't really use a gel pot eyeliner. I usually just use my regular eyeliner. Do I need to? Maybe not. Let me tightline. I am all over the place, as per usual. Because I am not wearing eyeliner, I am going to put on falsies before mascara. So there's that. Just because I can then position them a little bit better. So let me do that. So everything is on, and here is the finished look. So I finished off the look with a little bit of blush and highlighter and lippy. Everything will be down in my description box. Do I want to share the lippy? Yeah. Let me tell you the lippy that I have on my face. It is actually, this is the lip liner that I also use as eyeliner, the one from Essence. And the lip is the I Heart Revolution Vinyl Cherry in the color Cherryade. I will leave a video in the corner and down in my description box of me swatching all the shades that are in that range, because I have done so. So yeah, falsies are my more natural ones from Primark in the style London. Let me give you my quick verdict. Do I think they are worth the money? Definitely. I paid 13 or 14 euros for the set, and the set contains
3, 6, 9, 12.
The set contains 15 brushes, so say it's a euro per brush. So not bad at all. I also really like the aesthetics of it. Yeah, I like them a lot. The ones I used almost all, you saw how I use them, and that is probably the way that I will use them as well. I really like them. I do have some favorites. I think these two will be my favorites. Yeah, and this one. Ah, hell, this one is also very, very nice. So, yeah. Wow. Anyway, when you get them home, wash them with a soft shampoo and then a little bit of conditioner. Rinse them out, you know, and let them air dry. That way they are very nice and soft and still pick up a lot of shadow. These are my favorites out of the set. I like all the brushes, but these are the favorites just because of what I prefer and how I prefer to do my eyeshadow. So even for these four, 15 euros is a steal. Just saying. But yeah, I do want to give a shout out to a special brush in this one, which kind of really surprised me, and that is this one, the 233 cream shader. I have brushes like this. I have one from, I think I have even two from Biley. I have some other brand, Ducare, I think. Usually these brushes are not, I don't like them. They feel too cheap. They're too stiff. They don't want to pick up product. This one though really blew me away, because this one is still kind of, it's denser and a little bit stiffer, but it's still flexible enough. It picks up shadow. So yeah, this one is a very nice surprise in this set. And I think that is it. That is it for my first impression of the Jessup brush set that I got from AliExpress. It's the eye brush set that, again, I will leave down in my description box. I really, really like the set. That's basically it. Let me know down below if you have this set, or maybe a similar set, if there are some Jessup brushes that I need to check out. And yeah, let's chat about it in the comment section. That is it for me. I'm going to sign off. I'm going to walk the dog and almost make dinner, because it is almost that time again for me. Yeah, I'm rambling. That is annoying. So there is that. Let me just close off the video, because this is getting ridiculous. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so, so much for watching. Going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. And I will see you soon in my next one. Bye, guys. No, let's do it again.